We are actually right above the water. So one of the popular questions that people ask for us, everyone wonders if it's enough space for 300 birds to be able to swim inside this pool that's right here in the front part of the exhibit. Well, the pool doesn't just exist. So what Kaitlyn is doing right now, she's not just handing the fish over to the birds. And if maybe they're not hungry when Kaitlyn approaches specifically to hand feed them, well, what we do also is leave out a penguin buffet. So you're going to see that there are some different huts and trays actually all along the ice edge. What she has the opportunity to do is place a bunch of fish into that tray. They can approach it whenever they want.
There you go, feathers. Let's see this. No, they're like one. Show me all penguins on the other one.
It's true, huddling together is one way to stay warm. But how do these seabirds guard against heat loss in the frigid water and air temperatures? Four primary adaptations help them survive on their body fat that provides insulation, changes in their metabolic rate from their men, feathers. Their feathers are stiff and very thin. In fact, they're 7 times more dense than a chicken's.
Wow.
Thank you.